Tonight at 10, cracking down on violent crime with the tap of a button. Thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Simon Chiquette. Detroiters now getting access to a new mobile app to report on local public safety issues in real time. 7 Action News reporter Kira Hay shows us how it works.
Simon, city leaders are banking on this app and the name behind it to cut down on crime here in the city.
What up, though? What up, though?
New Era Detroit and its founder, Zeke Williams, building up quite the name and credibility for themselves in the city of Detroit.
We look at ourselves first and figure out what can we do better, you know, as people, and what can we do better as a community to really take things to the next level.
That next level, an app called Safe Zone, designed to have people living in Detroit report crime and send in anonymous tips. A member of New Era Detroit will come out to investigate the situation, not police.
This city is much too violent. Our police department is doing a good job, but there are folks that the government, that the police can't reach.
New Era Detroit, one of 6 community outreach programs, dividing $10 million to combat crime through the city's Shot Stopper program. The app can be downloaded right now under the name BLKEM. They will respond to a request in their zone, which is from Curtis to Schoolcraft in Wyoming to Hubble on the city's west side. So I went there and asked.
So would you download the app?
Yeah, I would. It seems like a good idea. It could be pros, but it also could be cons.
Shanice Draper believes one of the cons could be lack of confidentiality, with people in the city not trusting who they're reporting information to. But Williams says the app isn't replacing police.
If it's a community issue that the people of the community is able and willing to handle and take care of, then that's when people will reach out and will be connected to the app.
And community issues could be anything from a missing person, sexual assault, or conflict. New Era Detroit will also engage other resources like mental health services, security, and yes, police. Jaron Thompson believes the people living in the city will tap in.
I think that one of the biggest ways that we can resolve conflict a lot of times is, you know, amongst ourselves.
So. We anticipate to learn more about this app Monday night because Detroit's Mayor Mike Duggan will be hosting a community discussion where he's going to be talking about not only the app, but other community intervention programs. In Detroit, I'm Kira Hay, 7 Action News.